Come.
The rain just gave us enough time to get in the building.
So we've been talking those days that we are the children of the Mother Earth, the children of the Father Sun. We learn that it's about reciprocity. And the reciprocity is an attitude. Sometimes we can't be in reciprocity 100% as we receive. But ideal reciprocity is not only between human beings. Actually, all the expressions of life are reciprocal. But one of the ways that in the Indian world we are reciprocal is by doing the offerings. There is different names of offerings. Some people call payment to the Mother Earth. But you know, the payment comes from the wallet. The offering comes from the heart. So what we always do is an offering. And in the offerings we have different products, different elements, sometimes from different kingdoms, from the mineral, from the animal, vegetal, and even the human, sometimes from the underworld, from the abundance that we represent. Some occasions, the fertility of the two of the seven. It is the communion of the five kingdoms. And most of the time we talk about the kingdoms, about the mineral, vegetal, and animal. We have those kingdoms plus the abugunas, but plus first the human kingdom and the abundance. So we have five kingdoms that all of them, they are included in their offerings. The offerings we do in the Indian world in different kinds. You know, in the Aymara region there is like 35 kinds. So it's long. And for different purposes, there is some is only pure white, the white offering. Some other offerings pure candies, sweet offering. Some other pure good flowers. Some other offerings with the is a kind of metal like a lead. No?
Yes, a magnet.
Lead. The chinches. The little things, the messages that when we burn it dissolves easily. We have offerings for the goodies to return. Somebody has the idea that some heavy energies are arriving because some people is manipulating, you know, sorcery, all that kind of thing. So the offering that we are going to do today is the harmony with the seven relations. We've been talking about it now. One of the most important relations is the past that's in front of us. So we did this afternoon a little process in order to remember what is that we need to harmonize in our lives. You know, an offering is like a portal. The portal to connect with different realms, with the different relations, with the forces of the multiverse. You know, it's not only the universe, you know. because the power, the impact, it doesn't have limits. As you know, light can arrive to dimensions, the level that even we don't know. But the most important for us is in this reality, how we can read more peace, more harmony, more joy.
Krishna, right?
Because if we bring joy, that means we are in harmony. If we bring harmony, it means that we are in peace. If we have peace, it is because we are not attached to the heavy energies. Because when we are attached to the heavy energies, always jumps in one or other situation. So the heavy energy's expression most of the time, it is in the disease, in the different disharmonies. We have in our tradition different ways to harmonize using the elements. Sometimes, you know, we use water. The running waters always we take the solar plexus area to the neighbor, asking the water to take the message. And water always deliver the message to the mother, no matter what, because it is very much in service. And always the message, if it's not strong enough, waits that it becomes. If the water can go above, goes under. If it's impossible, at that moment just waits, evaporates, and passes. The water doesn't, there is no obstacles for the water to deliver the message. Water is wise. You know, when we are a little bit scared or very scared, our mouth is dry. The question is, where is the water? The water goes. So the water goes to the heart. With the Divine Mother, Divine Father, to keep us alive. But of course, at that moment, we need some water. But water inside, we are water. So, as water we are, we connect with the element, sometimes even without an offering. The power of love, service, and wisdom by the sacred. We see for water to the distance. We can use that to let happen to ourselves or to let go to the water. So we can use that connection with water. So, but when we work, because this area works with the water element and works with the emotional one, okay? So I was telling you that one of the legends that the snakes learn is they've been working with water, releasing. And one became in the rainbow and the other one in the light. So water is the way. Because the teaching of water to be flexible, to be clear, it is very important, it's always in service. And it has to do much with life. The other elements, like fire, of course, is so powerful. One of the ways how the Mother Earth heats is through fire. So always we can burn whatever we need to burn. Sometimes we do the ceremonies, burning the masks that we use. Sometimes after the heavy energy experiences. In life, to play cards with the society, with the community, sometimes with some masses. So, in order to release, to be free, to do that, fire is amazing. The connection with fire, but we want to work with always with the heart, with the drop, the air, the wind, always we can blow. In the Kayawaya tradition, some of the Kayawayas will blow to the south, to the sacred empty, the energies that doesn't belong to us. Once in a while, we can go to the nature, countryside. You know, nature always brings us back to our nature. And our nature is spirit. And we can connect with the spirit, with the soul of the wind, and ask to restore our soul. So, thank you. Tomorrow. So, we have the opportunity always to be with the Mother Earth. The Mother Earth is always open. We don't need really much to connect with the Mother Earth, except some humility, simplicity, less ego. We don't really need much in the mind. It's just about surrendering. It's about to be grateful to the Mother. So today we are going to do this offering. You know, those days are very special. With the moon, with special celebration. And I was a person, some teacher, it's a master.
Yeah, Babaji Krishna.
Well, anyway, our friends brought some petals also. We can bring to the mess and to the offering, not only for ourselves, but for our beloved ones, for to bring joy to their lives, even the ones that we don't love anymore, the ones that they are a little bit away from our lives. It's important to ask joy, because by some way that joy arrives. Because our relations not only for a moment, it stays all the time. So we try to harmonize all the relations, also bless all our relations. That's another important aspect. You know, as much we bless, we are receiving that blessing. So, today we have great products, great food, goodies.
Pick whichever one you want.
Okay,
I
yeah.
know what I have.
Very good. This
already
is
packaged.
This is excellent. We're going to use confetti. What's the name of this? Confetti, huh?
It's candy confetti.
Candy confetti.
It's little sprinkles.
The petals of the roses always are great. You know, sometimes we use carnations, roses. We have the cantus, cantita, the national flower of Bolivia. Those are the fuchsia family. Those are very special. The Inca period, that was one of the main flowers for the offerings. But wherever we go, we can find roses, which are always ready for the service. And in one flower are many petals, so we can blow. The first thing we blow, you know, is with the invocation. And in the invocation, how we do the invocation, we do it from our soul, from our inner sun. So when we blow, it's not only air. Most of the time it's been just blow. But if we connect with that light, you know, it's a way to be focused that what we are bringing as an offering is the best of ourselves. And what is the best of ourselves is our light in our heart. So if we are focused into the petals or in the coca leaves and whatever we have in the hands, we bring the best, and that comes through our breath and with it. What is it? It's light. So we bring the light of the inner sun. Remember, it's reciprocity. When we bring the blessings from the multiverse, what we bring is light that we call the refined energies of different ways. So all light is to support light. That light is life. Life supports life. So how we share our life, what is the symbol of our life? It is our breath. So being aware that is important, that is sacred. I was telling you that everything that comes from the heart, when we connect with something coming from our heart, we are creating a sacred relation. This sacred relation, blowing, you know, with, you know, blowing to the spirit, to the Father, Son, to the apple, to the mountain, we are blowing the best, okay? And when you offer the best, everything is reciprocal. What you will get, you get the best. So, if we want to feed the soul with the best, we offer the best. And the best is our life. The best is what we are. That's part of the offering. But the other aspect, the other part of the ceremonies is always an opportunity to let it go. As much we let it go the past that's in front of us, we open the doorways of a new future. But a real new. Not the same with different formats. Usually happens. So we are also planting the seeds of what we want to grow, what we want to expand, what we want to manifest in this reality. Okay? So the offering is a portal that we open. As we open our hearts, as we open the resistance. It's not just a thing from the mind, okay, I have to do this because I have to pay the Mother Earth, otherwise I will get it. It's the offering comes from the heart, that's why it's very important. Nowadays, some of our friends still, I see in the newspapers even, they say, we do payments to the Mother Earth. That's from the colonial period. The Spanish point of view, pay. But this is the offering. And the offering really doesn't have price. It is our love. We can't measure. That's why we say love, we don't measure. So, do we have any questions? Preguntas.
Do you want me to turn a little light on?
You know, I was just saying, we've been saying this three, pieces of textile here. One of my teachers once, I was putting by some reason like this. He would say, "Oh, you have the pyramid already." I was looking, "Where is the pyramid?" So I have to see from the top.
Ah.
So it is three levels. The textiles. You know, the textiles, they're already creating a sacred space, because this is what we call, you know, the textiles are prayers to life. It's already an invocation there. It's already, you know, the directions, it's already the pathways, the connection. It's a language. This language is speaking to the cosmos. In the sacred geometry. Very good.
Do you want me to cut it smaller?
Oh, yeah, we can. In the meantime, I will.
How much more?
Just a square. So I will do the invocation of the names of divinity in the native language. You can do that with your own words, the own way, how you are used to do the invocation, okay? Mama pacha pasito, mama pacha pasito. open to share our love, to share our gratitude. Today, to bring peace, to bring the light to the leaders who guide us in this world. Thank you for the light. You've been in the regions where the heavy energies are trying. We are grateful for the light that brings harmony and peace. Okay, so who has the petals? Okay. So you would hold the petals first with the blowing, as we said, the best. The petals, remember to put your light.
I think it might be like sugar.
You are putting your intentions. you want to let it go?
Thank you.
house and gratitude for all the houses, everybody's here. The alive houses there. With much gratitude for the love, service, and the wisdom of the house.
I came back from Peru. I have on
the corn that is the abundance. Mama Sara is always ready for service. Like Mama Cuca, we will mention. We represent Mama Cuca in some people here. And Mama Sara together, the two important daughters.
I
body from the offering. Different ways, you know? Sometimes there is a tree, a heart. Suddenly it starts to come the bag, the medicine bag, the bag of the offering. The joy, the celebration, the color, every now we are going to put from our hearts. We've been activating the hands, remember? It's always with a blessing. So after we cover this, become in a healing tool. So we can use to take away some of the energies we don't want to carry. Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you, everybody. Thank you. today the restaurant is further. We are grateful today. For all the directions you came, we are grateful that you are happy in service now, for cleanse and for healing. So I will pass around, so one at a time, the ones who want, okay, to do, to see what you did, cleanse, okay? Cleansing, limpieza, purificación, there are different ways, you know. You just bring the offering. So now you hold in your hand, in your heart, wishing that it manifests the intentions of very high from the others. Okay, if you like, you can do the other person for you. The world is Jokisen, Jokisen, go away. Everybody's a healer. Everybody has healed ourselves. We can always do that cleansing. Because the idea is that when we move heavy energies, when we move energy, some of the heavy energies want to return immediately. So what we want to keep away. So we use thank you. we are going to keep in the altar. The offerings always is a great celebration in the Andes when we do an offering. Then is the dances. Then is the drinking, eating. Dance is the next step of the ceremony. All the dances originally in Peru, the Andes, started with the offering, with the ceremony. And the closing really is the dance. But at least here we are going to give the hugs to each other. But on the high plateau, we call the, in Spanish, we use the word buena hora. So whatever was our intention, whatever we brought into the offering, was a great moment, a good moment. So the moment is great, okay? Because we have to celebrate. It's like to congratulate each other that we put what we release, we put the seeds, we send the message in a good moment, okay? That is the meaning of buena hora. Okay? Buena hora! Then have sex each other. Buena hora.
Buena hora.
Buena hora.
Buena
hora.
That you connect or reconnect with the circle. That is eternal. We keep returning to the circle. And we will keep returning to the circle. So we said to Pananchistama, will mean that until we see each other in any reality. So being in a meditation, in a dream, in a solar practice, connecting with the Father, Son. But always it's joyful to see each other in this reality. Okay? So I hope to see you in Peru, or I hope to see you in another time. Okay?
And on that note, Jacqueline could talk about a trip that she is helping create with Jorge.
Yeah,
if you want to watch, if you look, really like this wonderful guy, and you want to be your tour guide for all of Peru, as far as Lake Titicaca and Cusco, the heartland, the capital of the Inca Empire, to all the sacred sites in the sacred, in the Sacred Valley, and up into Machu Picchu.
August 26th, you leave this area. August 27th, you arrive at Cusco for 14 days, 13 nights. And you leave September 10th, and you arrive on
September 9th, right on September 10th, and then travel days. But it's 13 breakfasts, and a welcome dinner, and a closing farewell dinner, and a lunch and dinner when you're out in the islands on Lake Titicaca. And price-wise, we're looking at the double occupancy around, per person, like $2,500. Airfare, because you can make a lot of flights from, whether it's Philadelphia, I live in Pittsburgh. So Philadelphia to Miami or Dallas or Atlanta, then you gotta go to Lima, then you gotta get a flight to Cusco. So you're looking at ballpark, like $1,600, roughly, what that looks like. But what we're asking for is like $600 deposit, and then we'll break a couple payments over the years. This is for 2017, so give you time in advance, not 3 months, but like a year, to like say, oh, I can set this aside. And we also have, so you have Jorge, the guy through the entire 14 days. And then I worked it out that one of the Caro elders, Don Francisco Charles Flores, who's also a shaman, but he'll be with us in the Sacred Valley for a couple days, maybe Cusco. We're still, you know, negotiating, but we try. So it'll be really nice because you'll get different aspects of actual Morale and Caro, you know, trained shamans. And so we're calling this more of a pilgrimage as opposed to just tour, because there'll be sacred ceremonies every day along the way. So it's more of a pilgrimage. And once you go on a pilgrimage and then you go do a tour, it's like, eh. And you miss that sacred ceremony every day, and it's attractive. So I sent a flyer.
So I can forward it.
Forward it that you can print off that I just approved last night. I mean, I have it. So I just sent it out like last night to you, so I just got it all. I was kind of excited. It's someone who was actually one of my friends that was an editor for a magazine, and she got, and I had this kind of 3-page thing, and she took it, and I had this beautiful green this and this and that, and it was like, oh, this is so professional. So now it's 2 pages, and it looks like a couple of nice copies. So you can get it from Candy.
If you just email me, I can forward it to you if you would like to.
But it'd be nice since we sort of met already, sort of, to go when you know people, so you can get, especially, you could do, so I even set up the rooms that if you're married, they're what they call matrimonial rooms, and if you're single, you can have your room by yourself, but most times, because it's cost effective to have, double occupancy, so if you know someone here you could want a room with, that'd be kind of nice too, because that way you can know different people just by meeting them here, so, or one of your friends, sister, relative.
And Don Francisco is the lineage that I bring.
Yes.
So when I came back from Brewing, y'all said I felt like he was sitting there.
Yeah.
That's who was sitting there. You know, that's who all the textiles that I have and the Mastanas, they're all from, like, they went through ceremony all through Brew with Don Francisco, and I purchased them at the end. So it's what I walk with. It's what we sit in ceremony with every month is with that lineage line through him pretty much directly. So, and now we know.
Perfect.
Right? And his medicine.
A great team.
Great team. Great team.
Yes.
Yeah. I mean,
Jorge is trained by the ancient ones. There's another set of shamans from Lake Titicaca, where Don Francisco's from the High Andes Caro. So, on this tour, you'll have both of the lineages, and which is amazing for shaman.
Yeah. Very few opportunities.
Yes.
We have really to give a gift to the soul. We've been talking about the importance to be the soul, and in a pilgrimage like that, it's really unique. Many people talk about their lives before and after birth, and it's about the experience. It's not that somebody tells you this happens. And every time it is keep expanding, but unfortunately also by some reason some of the temples they are closing. It's more and more places. So if you come early, don't wait too long. If you wait 20 years, maybe you will see Machu Picchu with binoculars on the next mountain.
Because they will be closing that. They will. I was just there last year, and they're saying they're going to let less people in.
So. It's an opportunity, and the program, as we've been talking, is different than what most of the people want. We don't want to see only Machu Picchu. We want to be Machu Picchu. We become one with the lake, dreaming of these big boats. It's really amazing. Dreaming under the flame of the Divine Mother. You just feel that water of the womb of the Mother, It's a rebirth. It's unique, huh? You remember these experiences. Everyone who went to Peru, and some people went once, twice, three times. Every time we go, it's something different. It's always great. But some people go with one other tours, typical, traditional. It's shame. It's not nice to say, maybe, but they lose much. I mean, the way how you approach, the way how you get into the places, it makes a huge difference. And of course, with the cosmology, we are not only seeing with the physical eye, but using the places for release, using the places to expand ourselves. It's really unique. So thank you it's open, you can tell to your friends. You know, the best way to be grateful, one of my teachers told me, is to share what you learn. Is that's the training. So if we get something, we share, and that's when we really confirm what we are getting. Okay? So, to Pananchi's come out. Unless we have some questions or something, we wanna. Mucho gusto.
Mucho gusto.
Hey. And the chef is over there.